Soldier Boy Tour. Hey, I got the new dance for y'all called the Soldier Boy. You gotta punch, then crank back three times from left to right.
Greetings, radio listeners. This is JDShadow. This is my first time on radio, I'm sure you all know. I'm as excited as you guys are. This is really insane. I can't believe it's really happening. Wow. I had a great weekend. It was pretty awesome. I went out and saw a movie that I've been anticipating for a while, Iron Man. It was good. It was your standard comic book hero movie. It was a very good, but not really, nothing, didn't really bring too many new ideas to the comic book movie, just the whole thing in general. It was good, but it's not going to be, there's no way that it will live up to The Dark Knight, because The Dark Knight is going to be superb. Heath Ledger's farewell performance is just going to blow us all away. It's going to blow our minds. But on the topic of movies, this is a little surreal for me. Anybody who knows me well knows that Nicolas Cage is a personal hero of mine. He brought me back from the depths of my own depression on several occasions just with his movies. He's an amazing human being. And so the reason this is surreal is because, believe it or not, we have Nicolas Cage on my show today. He is on the show. We are getting him on the line. All right, Christy? Christy, is Mr. Cage on the line right now?
JD.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God!
JDShadow, how's it going, man?
Is this seriously Nicolas Cage?
This is Nicolas Cage in the flesh.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God! It's Nicolas Cage. Okay, I need to be more professional than this. Oh, my God.
I gotta say, man, it's good to be here. You know, things are going well for me. It's good time to be Nicolas Cage. What can I say?
It must be, because your career is just at its all-time high right now. What's the next movie that you're working on, Nick?
Well, I want to make a sequel to The Wicker Man. Have you seen The Wicker Man?
I have seen The Wicker Man.
It was a great movie. And I figure it was a remake, but they didn't make a sequel to it. So why not make a sequel? Why not go where they haven't gone before? You know, and I figure Edward Malice will play the ghost of Edward Malice, and he will come back and try and challenge the authority of the island.
Huh. Sounds interesting. I'm intrigued.
Absolutely.
You know, I got to bring this up, Mr. Cage. I was debating about whether to do this, going back and forth. I'm a little nervous about this. I don't know how you're...
Bring it on. I want to hear it.
All right. I'm on the official Nicolas Cage message board, and
okay.
I'm reading, and there's this forum troll. His name is Nicolas Cage Sucks. I can't say the next word, but Nicolas Cage Sucks blank.
Okay. Yeah, I've seen that guy. I've received mail from him.
And he's saying these things. One criticism, and I'm not saying I believe this because I don't believe it at all. I think it's kind of absurd. He's saying that all of your characters are the same, that you play the same character in most of your movies. What do you have to say to that?
Well, absurd would be an understatement. That is absolutely not true at all. I don't see how that's true at all. First of all, they all have different names. They live in different places. They have different jobs. And the only thing about them that's similar is that they look alike, because they're played by me. That's really the only thing that you could say that they're similar about. That's ridiculous. That's preposterous.
I bet if this forum troll is listening, he's feeling like he just got in the face.
probably. You know, he doesn't have much of a life, anyways. I'm sure.
I would guess so. I don't want to seem unprofessional, but it is just so amazing, Mr. K. We have you on the phone today. It's just amazing.
Yeah, you know, it's essential to communicate. Communicating is so important for us to do. It's a passion of mine, and it's something that we need to do as humans in order to survive. You know what I'm saying, JD?
That's very insightful. I gotta kind of stop you there, though. How is communicating a passion? What do you do to kind of...
Well, you know, I talk on the phone.
Like we're doing right now, okay.
Yeah, I talk to people in person, and
that's fun for you. You think of that as a passion?
It is a passion because it's essential, and I love to do it. Yes, it is a passion.
So breathing is essential. Are you saying that breathing is a passion?
It could be if you pay attention to it, if you give it effort. Yes, breathing could be passion.
One of my favorite movies, probably my very favorite movie of yours, is Lord of War. Would you just like to talk about, you know, anything that comes to mind when you think of your experiences making Lord of War?
Well, you know, it's about a arms dealer, Yuri Orlov, and he goes to Africa, and Africa is a continent, and you know he sells guns to these people, and consequently they kill each other. And that is, you know...
It's tragic. It's very tragic.
I know, but it happens all the time. Yuri Orlov or not, he's not the criminal here. The criminal are people in real life who are doing this. And it shows that people who are hungry and poor will shoot at each other if they have guns. And it's you know, they make a valid point at the end that the U.S. deals more arms than anybody. And, you know, people who have guns tend to shoot at each other. Is something funny? Did I make a joke? This is very serious here. Are you laughing? What was that? What? Hey, don't do... What are you doing?
I'm sorry, Mr. Cage. We just got a little bored with what you were saying, and we decided to start having some fun with the effects.
Do sound effects on your own time, okay?
This is my own time. This is my radio show.
Yeah, but I'm your guest, okay?
Look, no offense, but I mean, this is my show, and I think I know what's entertaining, and I don't think people want to listen to you babble about Africa or whatever other crap
you
had.
Maybe they do. Maybe they do, JD. You know?
No. We actually have a bunch of calls right now saying that they don't want to hear about Africa.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, fine. JD, are you... come on. Stop that. Okay? You know what? That's not necessary. JD, I thought you were a fan.
I am a fan. It's just...
Okay.
I mean, I was a fan, but now that I've heard you talk...
What's your favorite Nick Cage movie?
I said Lord of War was my favorite Nick Cage movie.
Okay, other than Lord of War.
Wow. There's so many, I don't know. Snake Eyes. Or Fast Times, I would say, is another favorite.
Fast Times at Ridgemont High.
Yeah.
That's your favorite Nicolas Cage movie other than Lord of War.
Yeah.
I was in that for like 2 seconds. Are you serious?
Yeah, now that you bring that up, that's probably why it's my favorite.
That's rude. That's rude. What? All right, other than...
You know what I say to that? You know what I say to that?
What? Hey. No. Don't do that to me. For any movie that I was in more than 10 minutes, other than Lord of War, what was your favorite movie of mine?
Man, I don't know.
Come on, it shouldn't be that hard.
I guess Ghost Rider. I'm a big comic book guy.
Ghost Rider.
Yeah.
Did you say Ghost Rider?
I did. I said Ghost Rider.
That movie was f***ing terrible. Are you serious, Ghost Rider? You're not a fan at all, are you?
You know what? Screw this. I was supposed to pretend that I was a huge Nicolas Cage fan. They made me do it because they said that you would be uncomfortable if I wasn't. And you know what? You're absolutely right. I think you suck.
Hey.
You are terrible.
Hey. You know, JD, you're fat. You know what? You internet hotshots think that you can just talk to anybody any way you want. You don't realize that you are talking to celebrities and you can't treat them the same as you treat
them. This is the official song of Nicolas Cage.
Hey, don't interrupt me. You know, this is Hollywood is more powerful than the internet will ever be. You know, you can't play me off. Don't try and play me off. I'm talking right now. Stop playing me off. You need to show me some respect. Jesus Christ, what the hell is this?
Wow. That was one of the most disappointing moments of my life. Nicolas Cage, like I said, I kind of had some respect for him. I thought at least it would be just be exciting talking to a big star I've heard of, but... Damn, that guy is a douche. A complete douche. Well, that's going to do it for... what's that? I've just been told that I will not be coming back for another show. This will be my last show on the radio. That's also a little disappointing. Turns out Nicolas Cage can ruin more careers than his own. Okay, so we will see you back on YouTube. You'll see the shadow when the sun comes up. Peace.
I'm off to join the circus. Gonna be a broken-hearted clown. Paint my face with a good-for-nothing smile. Cause a mean, fickle woman turned my whole world upside down.
Penis.